I see it in your eyes. You can feel it from my heart. From here on after, let's stay the way we are right now. And share all the love and laughter that a lifetime will allow. I cross my heart and promise to give all I've got to give to make all your dreams come true. In all the world, you'll never find a love as true as mine.
All you ladies are beautiful. You may be too far away. You put me in some place.
You will always be the miracle that makes my life complete. And as long as there's a breath in me, I'll make your rest as sweet. As we look into the future, it's as far as we can see. So let's make each tomorrow be the best.
All rise, please.
I set out on a narrow way many years ago, hoping I would find true love along the broken road. But I got lost a time or two, wiped my brow and kept pushing through. I couldn't see how every sign
this woman to this man in marriage?
My mother and I do. David?
No.
Take care of it.
You may be seated. On behalf of Kristi and David, I would like to thank all of you for being here today. Sorry, I had to put on my eyeballs. I didn't do that. For taking the time and making the journey, and for all the efforts that it takes, not only to be a part of this day, but to be a part of each other's lives. David and Kristi have invited you here to this most beautiful place to show you the glimpses of an important piece of their love, of this love that they have found, to share with you this new adventure they are undertaking together, to share in a celebration of their wedding. At this time, Kristi and David would like to take a moment to honor those loved ones who are not with us today. So if you will please remove your hats, gentlemen, and let's have a word of silence or a moment of silence. Thank you. The ceremony of marriage in which we come to unite is one of the first and oldest ceremonies in the entire world, celebrated in the beginning in the presence of God Himself. Marriage is a gift in that we give ourselves totally to one another. Marriage is the clasping of hands, the blending of two hearts, the union of two lives into one. And your marriage must stand not in the authority of this day, nor in the seal on your wedding certificate, but by the strength and the power of the faith and love you have for one another. God's word tells us in the book of Ruth, chapter 1, verse 16 and 17, where you go, I will go. Where you stay, I will stay. Your people shall be my people, and your God my God. Where you die, I will die. And there will I be buried. May the Lord do so to me, and more also, if anything but death separates me from you. Please again join me in prayer. Gentlemen, if you remove your hats. Father, hand in hand we come before you. Hand in hand we are stepping out in faith. We who are gathered here ask that you would take this couple into your hands, bless their marriage as they begin their journey down the road of life together. We don't know what lies ahead for the road that turns and bends, but help them to make the best of whatever comes their way. Help them to continue to enjoy each other as they did when they first met. Help them to realize that nothing nor no one is perfect, and to look for all the good in all the things of all people, including themselves. Help them to respect each other's likes and dislikes, opinions and beliefs, hopes, dreams, and fears. Even though they may not always understand them, help them to learn from each other and to help each other grow mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. Help them to realize that no matter what happens to them, they will hold on to each other and know that things have a way of working out for the good. But most of all, dear God, help them to keep lit the torch of love they have now, that they now share, and bless them with eternal happiness in their bond together. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
1 Corinthians 13, verses 4 through 8. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking, and it is not easily angered. And it keeps no records of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. The most remarkable moment in life is when you meet the person with whom you're to share a bond so special that it transcends normal relationships and becomes something so pure and so wonderful that you can't imagine spending another day of your life without them. Love is a force more formidable than any other. But although this love joins you together as one, remember the gift of your individuality. Cherish and affirm your differences as you love each other. Be supportive of your strengths and tender towards your weaknesses. To symbolize the importance of each of you within the marriage and the joining of your two lives into the marriage, two colors of sand will now be combined in a sand ceremony. David and Kristi will each separately pour their sand into the vase, symbolizing who they are as individuals. Then, as they pour together, blending the two colors as a symbol of the joining together forever in love. Though the vase may be moved around, the colors may shift, and may blend in new ways, the grains of sand cannot be separated. They will remain joined in a harmonious whole. May your love be as eternal as the inseparable and as inseparable as this sand.
I can catch it.
ketchup bottle. I'm shaking too much. Do it the other way.
Just over. Shake it up a little.
These are sands from Hawaii, by the way.
Of course, yours works. There you go. Come on. Just a few more ketchup bottles. We'll be done.
Kristi and David have written their own vows that they're going to say to one another. So.
I, David, take you, Kristi, to be my wife and my best friend in this adventure we call life. I will always be there through the good times and the bad. I promise to always show you what you truly mean to me. And I will always love you, respect you, and cherish all the little things about you that I love so much. Okay. I promise to always be a shoulder to lean on and to show unconditional love through anything life may throw our way. I will forever be loyal, honest, and patient as you have always been with me. I shall forever know deep in my soul that the good Lord put us together to show us both what happily ever after feels like, and I will spend my entire life showing you how true it is. You never gave up on me and my stubborn heart, and I promise to never give up on us. Through the good and the bad times, I hereby promise to treat you the way a queen deserves and to love you forever and a day.
Not yet.
That was so hard.
I, Kristi, take you, David, to be my husband and my partner in life. I will cherish you, trust you, honor you, and respect you. I will laugh and cry with you, loving you faithfully through the good times and the bad times that life brings us. I promise to grow with you, learn with you, and lean on you when I need to, even when I don't want to. I will be forever loyal, honest, and patient, and always give you the best of me. I will keep my faith in us, in you, and the life that we have built together. I promise to build you up and stand by your side unconditionally and always be ready for the next adventure. You taught me to look on the bright side of life, and I promise to carry that lesson through every moment of our marriage. And I promise to love you always, forever and a day.
Is that an I do moment or what?
Not yet. Not yet. Not yet. Not yet. Whoa there, Trigger.
My makeup's running.
Same.
Okay, it's waterproof.
Kristi, as you place this ring on David's finger, please repeat after me. With this ring, I marry you.
I marry you.
And bind my life to yours.
And bind my life to yours.
It is a symbol of my eternal love.
It is a symbol of my eternal love.
My everlasting friendship.
My everlasting friendship.
And the vows we have made to each
and
other.
The vows we have made to each other.
I ask you to wear it.
I ask you to wear it.
Think of me.
Think of me.
And know that I love you. David, as you place this ring on her finger, repeat after me. With this ring, I marry you.
I marry you.
I bind you.
I
bind my life to yours.
I bind my life to yours.
It is a symbol of my eternal love.
It is a symbol of my eternal love.
My everlasting friendship.
My everlasting friendship.
And the vows we have made to each other.
And the vows we have made to each other.
I ask you to wear it.
I ask you to wear it.
Think of me.
Think of me.
And know that I love you.
And know that I love you.
Now, Kristi, do you take David to be your husband? To have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish as long as you both shall live.
I do.
David, do you take Kristi to be your wife? To have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish as long as you both shall live.
I do.
Therefore, by the virtue gifted to me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ in the great state of Texas and now Colorado as well, I now pronounce you man and wife. Please turn to the crowd. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Woodham. Up there. Thank you all for being here, and may God bless you.